Cash grabs. Cash grabs are the worst things that can happen to a story, because at the end of the day, right, so for instance, a book succeeds, then they make it into a movie. A movie succeeds, then they make it into a video game. A video game succeeds, then they make it into a movie. I really, really, really abhor cash grabs. And I want you to understand that, because it is going to be a big factor in you understanding why I think the, you know, TV adaptation for Poppy World could actually, you know, get ruined, right? But on a fundamental level, there is really not a big problem with cash grabs. Because let's say you are successful as a, you know, video game, you can make a movie and then turn more profit. There's nothing wrong with that. But the issue here is that when your objective is to make profit, when your objective is to make money, the story gets forgotten, because the story at the end of the day is about artistic expression, and money is about capitalism and how much capital you can make out of a property that you own. And that is a big, big issue. That's something that scares me. I'm doing daily uploads, so please, if you like the content, if you enjoy, please consider subscribing. Please, 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 please. It helps out a lot. The fact that you are here means you are entitled to tell me what you would like to watch, and I will try to make that for you, as long as it has to do with books and storytelling. So, go on and tell me what you think down in the comments below. The question here is, what are the things that can ruin the Poppy World adaptation? Here is a list of some of the worst adaptations to have ever been put to page. You have got The Hobbit. Of course, this one's a classic. It's the classic cash grab. If there is a cash grab out there of a movie adaptation of a particular book, The Hobbit in this particular case, this would take the throne. This would literally take the throne. Then there's the Book Thief adaptation, which actually fails to capture the heart and the charm of the books. And then there's Wrinkle of Time, where they actually completely forgot about the characters, which was baffling to me. They literally forgot about the characters. There were no characters in this particular movie. But moving on, you see what is happening here. A lot of these were made in order to cash in. And that is a big, big dunk. That is going to be a big fat problem with this particular TV show adaptation of Poppy World. Of course, a lot of them have awful structure. A lot of them have notable things that you can point out and say, hey, look at this particular movie. In that point, at that particular, you know, instance, it messes up in this and this and this number of ways, right? Of course, you can do that, but a lot of them are just emblematic of this one giant, giant problem where these movies are made in order to cash in. And it makes me very sad. Of course, there's a solution to this particular problem. And the reason why it makes me very sad is because as you read Poppy World, I have finished the first book, but as you read Poppy World, what you will notice is that there's a lot of passion in the story. Rebecca Kuang actually displays a lot of passion for her story, for her character, and she puts a lot of effort to tell a story because she has a story to tell. But in this particular instance, I think and I fear that the story and what makes it good and the characters and the cultural aspects will completely be forgotten, and it will all be replaced with action and war, because there is a good number of that in this particular trilogy. And I fear from the bottom of my heart, those things will take over what actually matters at the end of the day, which is the heart of the story, which is the characters. And when you talk about money, when you talk about cash grabs, this is what is mostly harmed. This is what is mostly damaged. Look at every adaptation out there that is generally considered terrible. It is the characters. It's not the action. A lot of these have action that the books never had. They have amazing sets and they bring the world of the stories to life very well. But at the end of the day, because they're cash grabs, because the writers are not really taking this as a serious, you know, thing, and they're not putting passion into it, and to them it's mostly just a job that they have to get done, the character gets left behind, which is, at the end of the day, the hardest, most difficult thing to do in a story, structure-wise. Bringing a story to life, of course, the set, the money, the choreography, and all of that, and the actors is far more difficult. But at the end of the day, if you are structuring a story, that is what is most difficult, the character. And that's where a lot of book adaptations fail. They fail at the heart. And that, to me, is what scares me big time, because every adaptation I have seen somewhat fails to capture the characters and the heart of the story and the passion that was put into the book. And this, to me, is super, 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 super terrifying. I really love this particular trilogy. You do not get a fantasy book that is this good, very often. Of course, there's a solution, and one of those solutions is actually very good. Hire Rebecca as a consultant, at least as a consultant. She's not a screenwriter. Of course, I don't mean for her to write the screenplay, but she can give a lot of input. I hope that they can take Rebecca Kwong and actually include her into the process, because if they do not do that, I fear the fact that this is just mainly going to be a cash grab will take over and a lot of the story will be sidelined. But if they hire Rebecca, who has a lot of passion for her story, what will happen is that, you know, Rebecca will actually put in the passion to tell the story, because this is her story. And at the end of the day, she wants to get it right. She wants to put it out there. She wants to give it the best possible, treatment there can be. And to her, it's not going to be just a job that we have to finish. It's going to be my life's work. And she's going to put every bit of fire within her into that particular consultation, into smoothing out the structure, into making sure that the story works out flawlessly. This is the first of two videos. This one is actually just a general broad theme that can go wrong. But that is the first of two videos. This is just a broad general theme that goes wrong with a lot of book adaptations. In the next video, which will come out tomorrow, I will actually talk about specific things that can go wrong with this particular book and things that are difficult to get right with this particular trilogy. And so stay tuned for that. So today is a broad theme, tomorrow is a very specific theme. I hope that you enjoyed, and hey, I'm doing daily uploads, so if you want to help me out, please, 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 please consider helping me out. I hope that you enjoyed this particular video. Have a nice day. Bye.